गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इकोनॉमिक सेशन। आई एम प्रोफेसर देवकते पल्लवी एंड इन टुडे सेशन वी सी इंट्रोडक्शन टू एग्री बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट कोर्स। इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर देर इज वन कोर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, दैट इज इलेक्टिव इकोन 354। कोर्स टाइटल इज एग्री बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट एंड कोर्स क्रेडिट 2+1, that is total credit 3. In today's session, we see different topics covered under this course. So first topic, that is agribusiness. In this topic, we see the meaning, definition of agribusiness and agribusiness system, in which we see the different components of agribusiness, which are input sector, production sector, processing sector and distribution sector. Next topic, that is importance of agribusiness in Indian economy. After that, third topic, that is agro-based industries. In this topic, we see the importance of agro-based industries, then need of agro-based industries and classification of agro-based industries. Next topic, that is procedure to set up agro-based industries. After that, next topic, that is different financial institutions, in which we see the NABARD, NCDC, NDDB, APEDA, NAFED, etc. After that, next topic is agricultural value chain. In this topic, we see the concept of value chain and different activities such as primary activity and supporting activities in value chain. Next topic is business environment. In business environment, we see the pest analysis and SWOT analysis of business unit. Next topic, that is management function. In management function, we see different management functions such as planning, organization, directing, controlling, coordinating, and financing. After that, next topic is planning. In this planning topic, we see the meaning and definition of planning, then functions of planning, types of different plan, and characteristics of sound plan. In same planning topic, we see the steps in planning process. After that, next topic is organization. In organization topic, we see the legal structures, that is sole proprietorship, partnership, and corporation. Okay, in this topic, we see the characteristics, advantages, and disadvantages of all these legal structures. After that, next topic is organization structure. In this organization structure, we see directing, that is meaning and objectives of directing, then personal management, then recruitment people, selecting people, then orientation, compensation, fringe benefits, and evaluating performance, training and development, etc. After that, next topic is motivation. In motivation, we see meaning, different ideas of motivation, and different theories of motivation. After that, next topic, that is controlling. In this topic, we see the meaning and concept of ordering, then meaning and concept of leading, meaning and concept of supervision, meaning and concept of communication, etc. Next topic is capital management and financial management. In this topic, we see the definition of capital, then types of capital, and importance of capital and financial management. After that, next one, that is balance sheet. In balance sheet, we see the meaning, concept, importance, and precautions to be taken while preparing balance sheet. Also, in balance sheet, we see the different test ratios. Similarly, there is another financial tool, that is profit and loss statement. In this profit and loss statement, we see meaning, concept, and different test ratios in profit and loss statement. After that, next topic is marketing management. In marketing management, we see the definition of marketing, concepts of marketing, and difference between marketing and selling. In same topic, also we see the features of marketing concept. After that, next topic is marketing mix. In this topic, we see the 4 P's of marketing, likewise product, place, price, and promotion. After that, next topic, that is market segmentation. In this market segmentation, we see meaning and concept of market segmentation, then importance of market segmentation, and methods of market segmentation. After that, next topic is product life cycle. In this, we see the meaning and different stages in product life cycle. After that, next point, that is price policy. In this price policy, we see meaning of price policy, then objectives of price policy, different pricing methods, and pricing at various stages of marketing. Next topic, that is project. In this topic, we see the meaning of project, then definition and concept of project. Also, we see the different types of agricultural project, then project life cycle, in which we see the different stages in project life cycle, such as identification, formulation, appraisal, implementation, monitoring, evaluation, etc. Next topic, that is methods of project appraisal. In this topic, we see the different methods of project appraisal, in which there are major 2 methods of project appraisal, that is undiscounted measures of project appraisal and discounted measures of project appraisal. And last topic in this course, that is guidelines for preparation of project report. Okay, so this is all about theory syllabus of Agribusiness Management course. Thank you.